Welcome to another tutorial video. Today we will see how we can make a star delta motor operation in the PLC programming. Before starting, I would request you guys to please subscribe this channel by clicking on the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notification for the more upcoming video tutorials on this amazing channel. First, we need three contactors to make star delta wiring configuration. The first contactor will be called as power contactor, and it comes with an overload relay for the motor overload current safety. We will place them next to each other in this arrangement and do some standard wiring for the star delta configuration as shown in the picture. After completing the power wiring, we need a PLC so that we can start the control wiring. First, we will loop all the common points of the PLC outputs with a control phase. So the control phase goes into the common points of the PLC output relays. Next, we will connect the Y0 output of the PLC with the power contactor coil terminal A1. Now, if the PLC Y0 turns on, it will energize the power contactor. Similarly, we will connect Y1 PLC output to the delta contactor coil terminal A1 via normal close contact of the star contactor. This means that if the Y1 PLC output turns on, it will energize the delta contactor only if the star contactor is in off condition. Same way, we will connect Y2 PLC output to the star contactor coil terminal A1 via normal close contact of the delta contactor. In the last, we will connect the neutral line to the A2 terminals of the all three contactors. Now the PLC output wiring is completed, and we will start the wiring for the inputs of the PLC. We will connect the two push buttons with the PLC to the start and stop the motor. The green push button is the normal open push button, and the red push button is the normal close push button. We will connect the green push button with the X0 input of the PLC and the red push button with the X1 PLC input. Next, we will connect a signal from the normal close contact of the thermal overload at X2. So that whenever the motor is drawing more current, the thermal overload will give a signal at the X2 input of the PLC. We can use this signal to make a logic in the program to cut the power going to the motor and stop it and save its winding. So now the control and the power wiring is done, and we can go into the PLC programming step. But before we go, we will make our input and output table so that we can easily make the programming logic. So let's start with the inputs. X0 is a start normal open push button. X1 is a stop normal close push button. X2 is a overload normal close contact. Now the PLC output table. Y0 is the power contactor, Y1 is connected to the delta contactor, and Y2 output will be energizing our star contactor. Now let's start to make some ladder logic. In the first rung, we will put X0 start push button, the X1 star push button, and X2 thermal overload normal open contact in series with each other. If all three contacts are closed at once, it will turn on the M0 start bit. As you know that we have used X1 normal close push button, and the thermal overload contact is also normal close contact. That's why both contacts in the ladder logic are closed. In the next step, we will connect the normal open contact of M0 start bit in parallel branch with the X0 start push button. This is to hold on or latch on the start bit M0 if the start push button is pressed once. In the next round, we will take a normal open contact of the M0 start bit to start a timer T0. T0 timer will be used here to make a delay between star to delta transition. Next, we will connect our output Y0 power contactor and Y2 star contactor in parallel with the timer, so that the power and the star contactor both gets energized and motor start to run once the start bit turns on. In the next rung, we will use the normal open contact of the timer T0, and it will turn on Y1 delta contactor. This means that once the time is over, its normal open contact closes and turns on the Y1 delta contactor and turns off Y2 star contactor in the previous rung. Now the programming is done and ready to test the logic. We will upload the logic in the PLC and go online to monitor the ladder logic. Before we start to test, you can notice one thing, that X1 and X2 normal open contacts are closed and highlighted with the green color, because X1 is normal close push button with normal close contact, and X2 is a thermal overload relay with the normal close contact. Another thing, in the second rung, you can see that the normal close contact of the timer T0 is closed and highlighted with the green color. This is because right now the timer is off. Now let's quickly start and press the X0 green push button. As you can see that the X0 normal open contact is closed, and now X1 and X2 contacts are already closed. This will turn on the start bit M0. As soon as the M0 output turns on, the normal open contact of M0 also closed, and it will latch on the M0 start bit, and it will remain on even we release the green normal open push button at X0 PLC input. Now M0 start bit is latched on. It will turn on the timer, Y0 power contactor and Y2 star contactor. The Y2 star contactor turns on because the normal close contact of the timer T0 is closed. Now the power and the star contactors are turned on and motors start to run in the star configuration. Meanwhile, the timer T0 is also turned on and it will start timing for the 5 seconds. Once 5 seconds are over, the normal close contact of the timer T0 opened up and it will turn off the star contactor. And in the last rung, the normal open contact of the timer T0 closes. It will turn on the delta contactor and motors start to run in the delta configuration. If on any moment we press the start push button X1, it will unlatch the start bit and all the outputs of the PLC goes off and motor gradually stops. So this is how we can make a star delta program in the PLC. I hope you like it. Please share, like and subscribe for more videos. Till next time, take care and goodbye.